left.
Two hawk poofers free. Are they gonna be able to make more?
Almost certainly. A bittersweet spectacle, considering the cost.
The cost?
Aye. The adult's light fades as they pass it on to their offspring.
Hold on. Are you saying they have to die to have kids?
They don't have to, but the more light they give, the higher the chance of their offspring's survival.
Damn. That's... wow.
It is what parents do.
Really? All parents are supposed to die for their children?
It is what I would do.
Thank you.
Well, here it is. Guess it's time to free it.
You don't seem particularly happy about it, lad.
We're freeing them only for them to die. It doesn't seem fair.
Life seldom is. But their sacrifice will allow their children to thrive. So they will die contented.
I hadn't thought about it like that. If I were one of the children, I wouldn't want them to.
I know, son. But it is the only choice they can make.
Back to the surface, then.
You burn leaves and breathe the smoke.
Oh, can I use it?
No!
fate of these creatures. It reminds me of a story.
Yeah?
There once was a blacksmith whose king commanded him to construct a box that could contain all the evils of the world. But no metal could hold such power. So the blacksmith used the flame.
Father, please. It's okay.
What is okay?
You don't have to. Look, I know I get sad about this kind of stuff, but it doesn't mean I won't be okay, you know?
Yes.
So, what happened with the blacksmith?
His daughter was the key to unlocking the box. He died, trying to protect her from those who would open it.
You're not gonna have to do that for me.
I know, but I would.
Years we've overstayed our welcome in Alfheim. Yet again. This one's all yours, brother.
You know what? Never mind. Father, for doing all this. I know it doesn't solve everything, but it feels like we help.
No rush to leave yet, is there? Who knows what kind of adventures await us in a freshly lit barrens?
Thinking about what you both said, after what happened to Brock, that there are some things we just can't control. I know you were trying to comfort me, but how do we tell ourselves our fate is ours to make? Is that Freyr?
Indeed it is.
Wow, big statue.
That's odd. The runes are dark.
Why would the elves build a giant statue of Freyr? Didn't they just go back to fighting each other after he left?
Difficult to say without an inscription. But it looks like the elves built this place together. Light and dark. Which means this would have been their first act of cooperation in generations. A far cry from lasting peace, but perhaps it served as a monument. One that symbolizes the potential for peace.
This statue may have survived Freya's absence, but a truce clearly did not. Monuments are useless to those who ignore their message.
Couldn't he have just, I don't know, cast a spell or something? Made things better permanently?
There wasn't a spell or enchantment to leave behind. Freyr's presence is what mattered. His very godhood is what brought life back to this dying land. Eventually, he had to choose Vanaheim or Alfheim.
Doesn't sound like a tough choice. Vanaheim was his home.
It's never easy to walk away from those who meet.
There's already light inside these crystals.
You're right. Normally we'd have to provide our own. Perhaps slotting a crystal on the opposite side could shed some light on this mystery.
I knew you were gonna say that. Monuments are useless. Why are you trying to fix this one?
It was hidden for some time. Perhaps now it can serve as a reminder.
Aye. Nothing reminds people of their history like chiseled, well-lit marble. Looks like we can read the inscription now as well.
Light from the crystals. It is in the sand now.
Would you look at that? Freyr's gift endures after all. Or should I say, his presence?
You are not funny.
Father, do you think there will ever be peace in Alphon?
Peace is difficult after centuries of conflict. It must be found in its own time, from within. It cannot be forced.
But Mom helped you find peace, right? How are the elves supposed to change if no one shows them the way?
Your mother. She trusted me. Gave me the space to find my own way. But you are right, Atreus. She was my guide. Our actions in Alfheim may not bring peace. But by ending the storm and bringing light back to this land, perhaps we have planted the seeds.
Couldn't have said it better myself. Sounds like I'm rubbing off on you, brother.
It is possible.
So, Father's new spear, it's made out of a ring?
Got me an eye. Forged by the Hultr brothers as a gift for Odin.
How's it work?
Every so often, the Dropmir drips out identical copies of itself. The Huldras presumably figured that if one golden ring was a good gift, an infinite number of them would earn them a permanent place in Odin's heart.
But it didn't.
Not even a little.
Weird place for a lighthouse statue.
Isn't it? On top of ancient elven ruins? I'd have to agree.
Don't waste it! in! Attack!
So, which is your favorite of Gavassia's poems, brother?
Why would I choose a favorite? Answer be nothing.
What gets bigger the more you take away? Nothing. I don't think so, brother.
I do not like riddles.
Massive door we found earlier.
That door required two keys.
Aye, so is it. Let's keep looking then.
Whoa!
The Hiltcrest battle that grave will provide.
Yalti the Stolen!
Hey, Helka! That sword doesn't belong to you!
Don't worry about me!
What?
loyalty to Stolen.
You are nothing!
Oh,
Yalti the Stolid.
You are nothing! So easy! Go!
Shalti the Stolid.
That sword doesn't belong to you. You are nothing.
Yalti the Stolid.
This sword doesn't belong to you.
Take it off, man. You've got this. Yalti the Stolid.
Hey!
Helga!
That sword doesn't belong to you! I can't help.
Come on, Kratos! Off your back!
Hey! That sword doesn't belong to you!